Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends. Now this is a problem based on inventory management where you can carry out the regular production, you can carry out the overtime production, and then there is also a problem of shortage. In case there is a shortage, you incur some shortage cost or a penalty cost. Let's first read the problem and then try to understand how it has to be worked out. Problem number 8. Your own garment manufacturing firm of Mumbai wishes to develop a monthly production schedule for the next 3 months. Depending on sales commitments, the company can either keep the production constant, allowing the fluctuations in inventory, or maintain inventories at a constant level with fluctuating production. The fluctuating production necessitates working overtime, the cost of which is estimated to be double the normal production, and the normal production cost is 10 rupees per unit. So they are in a dilemma, they are in a confusion whether they should have a constant production or a fluctuating production. अगर प्रोडक्शन फ्लक्चुएटिंग रखा तो आपको प्रोडक्शन कम ज्यादा करना पड़ेगा, उस केस में आपको रेगुलर या कभी कभी ओवर टाइम भी काम करना पड़ेगा. रेगुलर प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट इज 10 रुपीज पर यूनिट. फ्लक्चुएटिंग इन्वेंट्रीज रिजल्ट इन ए इन्वेंट्री कैरिंग कॉस्ट ऑफ 4 पर यूनिट. इफ द कंपनी फेल्स टू फुलफिल इट्स सेल्स कमिटमेंट, it occurs a shortage cost of rupees 5 per unit per month. The production capacity for the next 3 months are shown in the following table. So they are also given as the production capacity and the sales. And we need to understand, we need to find out what can be done in this case to work out a solution of fluctuating inventories. Formulate it as a transportation problem to obtain an production schedule. Let's see what can be done now. First, we need to understand that the table uses capacities, regular capacity as well as overtime capacity. And we need to understand how it has to be calculated and how it has to be worked out. Now, there are 3 months. Month 1, month 2 and month 3. I can write the demand here on the downside against the columns, and I can have a regular production as well as overtime production. So here I'll write month 1 regular and overtime, month 2 regular and overtime, month 3 regular and overtime. Regular capacity, or I can say supply, regular capacity is 50 here and overtime is 30 here. In the second month, regular is 50, overtime is 0. In the third month, regular is 60 and overtime is 50. The next thing is now the demand or the sales. Sales for the first month is 60, for the second month it is 120, and third month it is 40. Now if you do the totaling, here it comes 50, 80, 130, 190 and 50. It comes to 240 as my total supply. 50, 100, 130, 190 and 50, that is 240. Whereas my total demand comes to 60, 180 and 40, that is 220. The first thing first, this problem is not balanced. Next thing is what cost I should fill in this particular table, in the cells. Now, our regular production cost is rupees 10 per unit. If the product is not sold in the same month, then we have to carry forward the product in the next month, for which there is the inventory carrying cost of 4 rupees per unit. Then we are also given that working overtime, the cost of which is estimated to be double the normal production cost of 10. So overtime ka cost aapka double hai. And last part is shortage cost, jo hum log baad mein picture mein aayega. So right now I will just put the regular cost for the first month as 10 rupees. Then regular cost for the overtime in the first month will be 10 plus 10, that is 20 rupees, double cost. अब अगर मैंने फर्स्ट मंथ में रेगुलर प्रोडक्शन किया और वो उस मंथ में सेल नहीं हुआ तो दैट विल बी कैरीड फॉरवर्ड टू द नेक्स्ट मंथ. इन दैट केस देयर विल बी ए इन्वेंटरी कैरिंग कॉस्ट ऑफ 4 रुपीस. सो मेरा कॉस्ट पर यूनिट हो जाएगा 10 प्लस 4 14. फर्स्ट मंथ में प्रोडक्शन लिया, फर्स्ट मंथ में सेल नहीं हुआ, सेकेंड मंथ में कैरी फॉरवर्ड हुआ. सेकेंड मंथ में सेल नहीं हुआ तो थर्ड मंथ में कैरी फॉरवर्ड हो जाएगा. अगेन देयर विल बी एन एडिशनल कॉस्ट ऑफ 4 रुपीस पर मंथ. सो 14 प्लस 4 इट विल बिकम 18. ये हो गया आपका फर्स्ट मंथ. अब ओवर टाइम में फर्स्ट मंथ में 20, फर्स्ट मंथ का फर्स्ट मंथ में सेल नहीं हुआ तो सेकेंड मंथ में जाएगा. कॉस्ट विल बी 20 प्लस 4 24 और थर्ड मंथ में होगा 24 प्लस 4 28. Then for second month, now see whatever is made in the second month can be sold only in the second month or in the next month, that is the third month. So second month mein hum log M1 mein kuch nahi likhenge because whatever is made in the month 2 can be sold only in the month 2 or month 3. So here it will be 10 rupees as the regular cost. सेकेंड मंथ का सेकेंड मंथ में बेचा तो 10 रुपीज रेगुलर कॉस्ट, सेकेंड मंथ का सेकेंड मंथ में ही बेचा ओवर टाइम में 20 रुपीज कॉस्ट. अगर सेकेंड मंथ में सेल नहीं होता है तो नेक्स्ट मंथ में कैरी फॉरवर्ड होगा. सो इट विल बी 10 प्लस 4 14, यहाँ पे 20 प्लस 4 24. सेम थिंग फॉर द थर्ड मंथ. नाउ व्हाट एवर वी मेड इन द थर्ड मंथ कैन बी सोल्ड ओनली इन द थर्ड मंथ. सो देयरफॉर द कॉस्ट विल बी रेगुलर कॉस्ट विल बी 10 रुपीज मंथ 3 अगेंस्ट मंथ 3. I won't get anything against month 1 and month 2 because whatever is made in month 3 can be sold only in month 3. It can't be sold in month number 1 and month number 2. For overtime, it will be 20 rupees. So, this is our formulation of the problem, and the biggest challenge in this problem is making the table. Once that table is done, now we need to check whether it is a maximization problem or minimization problem. You can see very clearly that this is a minimization problem because what we have noted on is the production cost. Second thing, is the problem balanced? In this case, I can say the problem, the demand and the supply, they are not equal. Therefore, the problem is not balanced. So, we need to resolve the table again and make the problem balanced. One more thing, in the month number 2 overtime, we don't have additional capacity as such. The additional overtime capacity is 0. Therefore, this particular row can be completely eliminated or ignored while working out the solution. So let's try to make the new table and work out the calculations. So we noted down the whole problem as it is, and now we need to balance the problem. If you look carefully, I have added a dummy column here, and the dummy column I will have a demand of 20. So this will be 60, 180, 220 and 2240. Now the next thing is, what amount I should put in this dummy. In general, wherever we have solved the problems, in almost 99% problems, it will be like dummy will always have the zero cost, because dummy are all imaginary numbers just inserted so that it will complete our solution, it will help us to complete the solution. But in this case, they are clearly specified in the problem. So in this case, there is a shortage cost of rupees 5 per unit per month, which means that I need to put a shortage cost of 5 rupees for all the unsatisfied demand. Therefore, I will put a shortage cost of rupees 5, 5, 5, 5, and 5 in all the cells of the column. Now, this is a full-fledged problem which we need to solve by our VAM method. Our first step in this case will be the VAM method. If you look in the row wise, in the first row, the lowest cost is rupees 5. Aapka sabse kam cost 5 rupees hai, and the next lowest is 10. So 10 and 5 ka difference aayega 5. In the second row, again I have the lowest cost of 5, and next lowest is 20. So difference will be 15. In the third row, lowest cost is 5, next lowest is 10. Difference shall be 5. In the next column, the lowest cost is 5, next lowest is 10, difference will be 5. In the next column, it will be 5 and 20, 15. Now we will go column wise, 10 and 20, 10, 10 and 14, 4, 10 and 14, again 4, and 5 and 5, 0. You can see the highest penalty is 15 rupees. My highest penalty is 15 rupees hai, aur wo do jagah par hai. Ek row mein hai, second row mein aur ek last row mein hai. Second row ka jo penalty hai, agar hum wahan pe allocation karenge to sabse kam cost aayega 5, where the supply is 30 and the demand is 20. So I can supply 20 here. Same if I take this 15, I can supply at the lowest cost, which is 5, 50 or 20, whichever is less, so I will supply 20. Dono jagah pe same allocation ho raha hai, to aap dono mein se kisi bhi cell ko ya kisi bhi penalty ko le sakte ho. So I will take the first 15, where supply is 30, demand is 20, so I will select 20 here, and 30 minus 20 shall be 10, 20 minus 20 will be 0. Since I got a 0 here, so we made an initial allocation of 20 in the second row, and since I got a 0 here, the demand is fully satisfied, we need to cancel this particular column. Ye column aapka cancel ho gaya. Column cancel kiya to aapka column penalties same rahega. So I'll note down the same penalties 10, 4 and 4. For row penalties, I'll again need to do the recalculation. It will be 10 and 14, difference will be 4. Lowest cost is 20, next lowest is 24, difference is 4. Lowest cost is 10 and 14, again the difference is 4. Lowest cost is 10 and there is nothing else. So, I will write 10 here. Next, it is 20 here as it is. Now, my highest penalty shall be 20. In this case, my lowest cost is 20, that is the only cell with the cost. So I'll put supply 50, demand 40, so I'll supply 40 here. 50 minus 40, 10, 40 minus 40, 0. So I got a 0 here. So this shall be cancelled. Since I cancel the row, I'll maintain the same numbers in the column. And for rows, I'll do the recalculation. 10 and 14, 4, 20 and 24, 4, and here there is only 10, so I will just note down the 10 here. And now I need to do again the recalculations. The highest penalty is 20 here. In this case, the highest penalty is 4, 4, 10, 10, and another 10. So 10 is the highest penalty. If you look at 10, the lowest cost is 10 here. So 50 or 120, I will supply 50 here. And 50 minus 50 will be 0. 120 minus 50 will be 70. Since I got a 0 in this row, I will cancel this row. Since I cancel the row, my row penalties will remain same. 4 and 4. And my column penalties will change. It will be 10 and 20. That is 10. 14 and 24. Again, it will be 10. So my highest penalty right now is 10. We have got two 10s. We can select any one of the two 10s. I select the first 10. Yahan pe sabse kam cost 10 hai. So yahan pe aapka supply 50 or demand 60 hai. So I will supply 50 here. 50 minus 50 will be 0 and 60 minus 50 will be 10. So I'll cancel this because I got a 0 in this particular row. And now what is remaining is we have 10, 60 and 10, that is the supply of 80, and we have demand of 10 and 7, that is 80. Now because we have cancelled the row, my row penalties will remain same and I need to do the column penalties again. So column penalty in this case, I got only one number, that is 20. So I will note down as it is. And in the second case, it will be 24. I will note down 24 as it is. Now the highest penalty I have got is 24. So in 24, my lowest cost is 24, where the supply is 10 and the demand is 70. So I will supply 10 here. Now we have redrawn the whole table again with all the supply and the demand and the cost factors, and now we need to understand how to do the allocations here. So the allocation method here will not be the normal VAM method that we normally follow in most of the problems. This being an inventory based problem, we need to understand how to work out the calculation. We'll go month wise. Whatever is made in the first month can be sold in the first month, or it can be carried forward to the next month. So in this case, in the first month, my regular production is 50 and overtime is 30. और मेरा फर्स्ट मंथ का डिमांड है 60, तो मैं फर्स्ट मंथ में एलोकेशन दूंगा 50 का, सो दिस इज ओवर, और यहां पे मेरा 60 माइनस 50 बचेगा 50, एंड इन द फर्स्ट मंथ ओवर टाइम वी हैव अ सप्लाई कैपेसिटी ऑफ 30 यूनिट्स, तो आई विल सप्लाई 10 यूनिट्स हियर, सो अगेन दिस 50 इज डन एंड इट विल बी जीरो. सो पहले मंथ का 60 यूनिट्स का जो डिमांड था, हमने रेगुलर प्रोडक्शन में 50 यूनिट सेल किया और ओवर टाइम में 10 यूनिट सेल किया. सो फर्स्ट मंथ इज डन. नाउ वी नीड टू चेक वेदर आई विल यूज द एडिशनल कैपेसिटी ऑफ द ओवर टाइम अवेलेबल फॉर द फर्स्ट मंथ इन द सेकेंड मंथ. आपका फर्स्ट मंथ का ओवर टाइम कैपेसिटी 20 है, जबकि आपका सेकेंड मंथ का डिमांड कितना है 120. सेकेंड मंथ में आपके पास कैपेसिटी सिर्फ और सिर्फ 50 का है. सो इन द सेकेंड मंथ आई विल गो फॉर द रेगुलर प्रोडक्शन ऑफ 50 यूनिट्स एंड आई विल यूज द 20 यूनिट्स ओवरटाइम कैपेसिटी ऑफ द फर्स्ट मंथ बिकॉज देयर इज नो ओवरटाइम कैपेसिटी फॉर द सेकेंड मंथ. फर्स्ट मंथ का ओवरटाइम कैपेसिटी हमने कहां पे यूज कर लिया, सेकेंड मंथ में यूज कर लिया, तो यहां पर बचेगा 50. इन द थर्ड मंथ वी हैव ए सप्लाई ऑफ 60 प्लस 50, वेयर एज आई हैव अ डिमांड ऑफ ओनली 40, तो आई विल सप्लाई 40 एट रेगुलर कॉस्ट एंड आई विल हैव ए अनयूज्ड कैपेसिटी ऑफ 20 रेगुलर एंड आई विल हैव एन ओवरटाइम कैपेसिटी ऑफ 50 व्हिच विल नॉट बी यूज्ड बिकॉज माय demand is fully satisfied. Now I need not go for Modi method in this case because there is no need to check anything. The only factor I will check is how much of the demand remains unsatisfied. See, month 1, month 2, month 3. In month 1, I am supplying regular 50 units. Overtime, I am supplying 10 plus 20. 30 units. 10 for the first month and 20 for the second month. In the second month, I am supplying regular 50 units and I don't have any overtime available. In the third month, I am using only the regular capacity of 40 units. Now we need to do the calculation. If you look at the total demand, it was 220. 60 plus 120 plus 40. Whereas my total production is 50, 80, 130 and 70. So there is a shortage of 50 units. Now I will multiply this with the cost per unit. Regular production ka cost aapka first month mein 10 rupees hai. First month ka overtime jo 30 hai, usme se 10 units ka 20 rupees cost hai aur baki 20 units ka 24 rupees cost hai because of the inventory carrying cost. Third month mein 50 into 10 aur third month mein regular 40 units multiplied by 10 and there is a shortage of 50 units in the second month. The demand is not fully satisfied in the second month. So, wahan par 5 rupees ka penalty lag jayega. So, my total cost will be 250, 400, 500. This will be 480 plus 200, 680. And this will be 500. Now I'll just add up all the cost. 330 rupees. This is my total cost. So this was a quite unique problem where we had a totally different way of doing the allocation based on what is my capacity, regular and overtime, and in which month I am making how much. Thanks for watching this video. Do subscribe to our channel eKrit.